Hi, I'm Rachelle, herbalist, holistic health practitioner, and your host of Plant-Based with Well and Good. And today, I'm your herbal bartender. I'm going to teach you guys how to make an herbal mocktail. This is my go-to. I do herbal mocktails almost every single day. I talk about it a ton. Lots of people care about it. Lots of people are asking, you know, what can I drink in place of alcohol? When you're making an herbal mocktail, it can be as simple as sparkling water and a tincture. So a tincture is a liquid herbal extract. And literally these two things can be a fantastic mocktail. But if you're, you know, in the mood for something that's a little more culinary and medicinal, or you're entertaining, or you know, you just want an experience that's a little more complex, then let's layer in some of these other elements. In terms of the herb for today's mocktail, I am using kava. And kava is my personal favorite herb that works as an alcohol replacement. Now, there are a lot of herbs that work as a replacement for alcohol. And the way to sort of find the right one for you is to think about the way in which you are or were using alcohol in your life. So was it to relax, you know, high, tense, stressed out shoulders? Is it to calm the mind? Is it for the culinary experience? Is it for the social experience? You know, all of the different ways that we sort of use that lubricant in our life can be replaced with herbs that do the same thing. So kava, I like because, I like it, and also it's been liked for thousands of years, specifically in the South Pacific, as a social lubricant and a physical relaxant that doesn't drunken the mind. So the active compounds in kava are called kava lactones, and they work by binding to receptor sites in the brain. Depending on the strain of kava that you have, it may be more euphoric, it may be more relaxing, but overall, it's something that is encouraging GABA production in our brain, and GABA is a neurotransmitter that helps us to relax. You get, you know, kava for nervous system and muscular relaxation. And literally, you know, herbalists, myself included, will recommend it for people to drop their shoulders, you know, because we end up like this. Kava can help us do that. So it's relaxing your body, but your mind is still clear. To make this mocktail recipe, to make this herbal old-fashioned, we are going to start with a couple of frozen cherries. Feel free to use fresh, if you have fresh. Two or three, okay? We are going to use some orange, so a slice of orange. Lemon, lime, orange, and grapefruit are high in something called terpenes. Terpenes are in the oil of plants, especially in the skin of citrus. And they are, among other things, really effective for mood. So we're doing a couple of pieces of chopped up orange. All right, so we're just going to muddle the cherry and orange slices down there. We are adding our tincture. I'm adding the kava. As mentioned, you can use any herbal extract that you like. And if you're making just a single serving, then you'll do just a single serving of the tincture. If you're doing a large batch of the mocktail, feel free to just do, you know, enough for each person to get a little serving. I'm also going to add some bitters. So these are herbal bitters, great for flavor, great for digestion. This has ginger. We also have orange again. So like doubling, we're actually going to triple up on that citrus and get more of those terpenes, more of those volatile oils, more of that mood support. These come in a spray dispenser. It's the same as a liquid extract. So whatever sort of bitters you have, love bitters for digestion. And then we are adding sparkling water. And you could use flat water, but I really recommend doing mocktails with sparkling water. It just gives it that extra bit of bite and sensation and kind of experience. And then let's do a little bit of cherry juice. So this just came from the container of frozen cherries. If you have cherry juice, you can use that, or any other juice that you like, but we're saying cherry orange. And this will be the natural sweetener, so you don't have any sort of added sugars in this mocktail. And then we'll do a little squeeze of lemon. It's my favorite kitchen tool here. Look at that. Can you see all of this oil just kind of coming out of the peel? Oh, that's so fantastic. It smells great. My mood is already improving. Okay. Beautiful. Yum. I'm so excited for this. This is perfect. I can't believe how good it looks. Not a bartender. Should I be a bartender? I'm just kidding. Here we have it, our herbal old-fashioned mocktail. It's sweet, it's sparkly, it's the kava is just sophisticated. This is fantastic. This is happy hour. This is dinner accompaniment, and it's your herbal mocktail. Thanks so much for watching. For more episodes of Plant-Based, subscribe to Well+Good's YouTube channel.